In the last video, we saw what is linear search, working principle, logic for writing the code, and the time complexity of linear search. In this video, we will learn about binary search. We already know that searching is the process of finding some particular element in the list. If the element is present in the list, then the process is called successful, and the process returns the location of that element. Otherwise, the search is called unsuccessful. Binary search can be implemented on sorted array elements. But in the linear search, we can perform the searching on even on unsorted array. If in case the given array is not sorted, we have to sort it first and then perform binary search. Let's see the working of binary search algorithm. There are two methods to implement the binary search. One is iterative and recursive method. Binary search works on divide and conquer technique. Let's see the working of binary search algorithm. To understand the working of binary search algorithm, let's take a sorted array. Here n is equal to 10, data is equal to 49. This is the element we are going to search for. As I said, binary search works on divide and conquer technique, which means it is going to divide the array into two halves. First, we will find the middle element of the array. To find the middle element, we are going to take two variables. First variable is 4. It is the left variable, so name it as L. Last variable is 81, name it as R, means right variable. Let's see how to find the middle value. Here the value of L is 0 and the value of R is 9. So to find out mid, we will calculate like this: left value plus right value divided by 2, that is L plus R divided by 2. And we are going to take the floor value of this. So the 0 plus 9 divided by 2 is equal to 4.5, and the floor value of 4.5 is 4. So the middle value is 4. We come across three cases while finding the element. First case, the element you are searching is equal to the middle element. In second case, the element you are searching is less than middle value. In third case, it is greater than the middle value. Data to be found is 49. Check with the cases, and it comes in third case. As the data value is greater than the middle value, that is 49 is greater than 25. So now you can say that data is present in the right subarray. We have divided the array with the middle value. But how do you tell so confidently that the data element is present in the right subarray? That is because the array is sorted. So all the data greater than middle value must be in the right of the array. Now we will have to search only in the right subarray. In the beginning, the search space was full array. After comparing and finding the middle value, we have decreased the search space into half. Now the left variable will be moved here. Our left variable will become mid plus 1. Now the left value is 5 and right remains the same, that is 9. Now again find out the middle value, that is 5 plus 9 is equal to 14 divided by 2, and the value is 7, right 7 here. Now the middle value will be moved here. Again it might be one of the three cases. Now check the data, and 49 is less than 63. So it is in the second case. Now we can say that the data is present in the left to the middle value. Left variable will be as it is, and right variable will be moved here. Right becomes mid minus 1. So now find out the mid value. Left is 5 and right is 6. Mid is equal to 5 plus 6 divided by 2 is equal to 5.5, and the floor value is 5. Now check if the 49 is same as the mid. No, it is greater than mid. So it is present in the right of the array. So now L becomes mid plus 1, that is 6. So move L here. Now find the middle value, that is 6 plus 6 divided by 2 is equal to 6. Now the middle value is 6. Check for the cases. Now data is equal to A of mid. We found the data. So here we are going to stop and return the mid value. It means return the index value 6. So far we saw when data element was present in the array. Next we will see what to do when element is not present in the array. Let's see how does binary search works on the array when the array doesn't have the element that you are searching for. Suppose if you want to search data is equal to 50. This is the left variable and this is the right variable. Left is 0 and right is 9. So the mid value is 4. Already you know how to find the middle value. So the middle value is 25 and 50 is greater than 25. So the data must be in the right subarray of the given array. As the array is sorted, the greater value will be right to the mid. Now the left variable becomes mid plus 1, that is 5, and right variable remains same. So the mid value will be 7. Check for the cases. Data value is less than the mid value, that is 50 is less than 63. Find in the left side of the subarray. Left variable remains the same and right becomes mid minus 1, that is 6. So the middle value will be 5 now. Check for the cases again. Data is greater than middle value. So the element would be in the right side. Left variable will be mid plus 1, that is 6. And right variable remains the same. And mid value becomes 6. Now check for the data if it is equal to mid. As you can see, it is greater than mid. So L is equal to mid plus 1. Now this is the stopping condition. If the value of L is greater than the value of R, it is the stopping condition. It means data is not present in the array. Now we will see the logic code. First we will create a function binary search. In this we will pass the array A, total number of elements in the array, N, and data you want to search. First we will take L is equal to 0, that is our left variable. R is equal to N minus 1. This is right variable. Then we will find the middle value. Mid is equal to L plus R divided by 2. Next, check the cases. That is, if data is equal to A of mid, return mid. If this condition is not true, then we will write else if data is less than A of mid. R becomes mid minus 1. Else, L is equal to mid plus 1. These all steps will perform while L is less than R, that is in a while loop, and returns minus 1. Minus 1 means data not found, and finally close the function. So this is how binary search works. Let's see the time complexity of binary search algorithm. We reduce the search space by half again and again until we find the data. So in such cases, the time complexity would be big O of log of N, and it is in the worst case. What would be the time complexity in the best case? Say for example, you are searching the data 25 in the array. And to find it, we will first divide the array by finding the middle value. So here the left variable is 0 and the right variable is 9. So 0 plus 9 divided by 2 is 4.5, and the floor value of 4.5 is 4. So here is the middle value and data is 25. So we found 25 in the first search itself. This is the best case, and in the best case, the time complexity would be order of big O of 1. Big O of log of N is better than big O of N, and big O of N is the time complexity of linear search. Please like the video, subscribe to our channel, and please hit on bell icon to get notified whenever we post new videos. Install DSA application from the Google Play Store or from the link given in the description below. Please let us know if you have any queries in the comment section below, and thank you for watching. Thank you.